Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. Iliana here, and if you're already part of this wonderful family, then thank you so much for continuing to watch and to support. I appreciate each and every single one of you. In today's video, we are going to just take a moment, sit back and relax, and just kind of chit-chat and get into a pretty serious discussion on just basically some tips that I have for starting social media and kind of my journey and where I am now and how I even started this whole thing. If you want to know the scoop, make sure to keep on watching. But before, as always, make sure that you subscribe to my channel, hit that notification bell so you are notified every single time that I upload. Make sure that you're following me on all my social medias. I will always be leaving everything linked down below as always. So without further ado, let's jump into another video. Hold up. Okay, so basically the number one question is, how did I even start my social media journey and here on YouTube? Basically, I made my YouTube channel back, I think it was in 2015, and I actually only did it for about 3 to 5 months. I really enjoyed doing it, but I was so busy because I was working 2 jobs at the time. I was also going to college, so it was just really hard for me to balance everything, so I kind of just let it go and didn't really, you know, touch base on it. I deleted all of my videos and everything, and I kind of just left it alone. And then back in 2018, which was last year, I actually started up my YouTube channel again. I basically fell through a really, really bad postpartum depression after I had her. My postpartum pretty much lasted the first 14 months of her life. So it was really, really hard for the first year that I had my daughter. I was really just not feeling myself. So that is why I basically started my YouTube again, because I just remembered how much I really enjoyed being on YouTube and just getting in front of the camera and speaking and just talking about makeup and giving tips and showing how I do certain things and, you know, all these things. And I just remember how much I enjoyed it. And I said, you know what, let me just log back into my YouTube. Let's just upload another video and see what happens. And so I did, and I kind of felt accomplished. Like, I felt like, hey, you know, I can do this again. So I started to kind of pick up. I made my page for Instagram. So once you become a mother, sometimes you get so sucked into just that, like 150% of me and my time and my capability was dedicated towards my daughter. She's obviously my world. I love her so much. I have another one on the way and I'm super excited. I wouldn't change it for the world. But sometimes once you become a mother, you kind of forget to take care of yourself. And that was, I think, my biggest struggle after having my daughter, that I kind of forgot to take care of myself too. That I needed self-love and I needed me time as well. So me doing my makeup and doing my makeup page and just making videos for fun was that me time that I so desperately needed. So that's kind of how it all started. I just kept going. I kept creating makeup looks and I just started seeing trends and new things that were coming out that weren't even a thing back then, like 5 years ago when I was doing makeup. So it just kind of made myself feel a lot better. And I kind of began to slowly get out of that funk that I was in. And it just really helped me overall, mentally, physically, and emotionally. So I kind of just stuck to it and I'm still here. So it's obviously helping. So basically some tips. Obviously, I don't have a huge following, but since I started these things, I have noticed that things have started to pick up a little bit more. I have 3 big rules and I'm gonna hit each of those rules individually. And then I'm gonna kind of get into other, you know, minor details that I kind of figured along the way. So my first rule is consistency is key. Now I'm going to keep glancing down because I have my little notebook here with all my notes that I have written down to make sure that I'm hitting each of these points that I want to talk about. So the first thing is consistency. Consistency is key. Now I know that sometimes it's very hard being a mother, being a student, being an employee of any company. You know, it's hard to have consistency when you have all these things going on in life. And then try to manage like your makeup page, makeup world, if you will. So obviously we kind of expect these bigger YouTubers to keep continuing to bring out new YouTube videos, to continue bringing new looks, to continue bringing new recommendations of new makeup that is out there so that we can try. So that's kind of what you're following, even if you have just 500, maybe if you have 60K, even 2K, these people that are following you for a reason, because they like your stuff, because they see that you're consistent, and because you have good quality, right? So that's what they're looking for. So that's what you gotta make sure, is you can't just post a picture, wait 3 months and post another picture, and then wait another 3 months to post another picture on Instagram and expect to grow that way, because it doesn't really work that way. You kind of have to think of it, not like a job, but you kind of have to think of it like people want to keep engaging. People want to keep talking to you. People like you. People are following you for a reason, so they want to keep engaging with you. So if you kind of leave those people hanging for months and then come back and then do it again for another 3 months, they're kind of like, okay, I'm not really gaining much by following this person, if that makes sense. So my second rule that I wanted to hit is that it is super important to have a schedule. It's like the number one thing that I have figured out has made my life so much easier. So obviously I have a daughter. Obviously I have things that I have to get done throughout the day as a mother, as a wife, and all that stuff. So I have kind of figured out a schedule. I bought myself a planner recently. If you guys follow me on Instagram, you saw that I did buy a planner. And within each week, I have pretty much wrote what I'm gonna do each and every single day. So before the week even starts, I kind of try to get it done a month ahead. So right now I have the entire month of September pretty much done, and I have every single week, I'm gonna upload this day, I'm gonna record this day, I'm gonna upload this day, I'm gonna record this day, and I kind of give ideas on what I'm planning on recording and uploading for that week. So right now I'm uploading once a week. My goal is to be uploading twice a week by the end of this year. Obviously, I have a baby coming next year, so I'm trying to get as many videos out as possible that are interesting and good quality, of course, before the baby comes, because obviously I'm going to have to slow it down a little bit with a two-year-old and then a newborn. So keeping a schedule is obviously going to be key, especially for us moms. Keeping my daughter on a sleep schedule, the best decision that I have ever made. Scheduling basically what you're going to do throughout the day, throughout the week, throughout the month is very important, and it has helped me significantly be a lot more productive. And I'm kind of more of a visual person, so if I see my schedule laid out, it just helps me like realize this is what I got to do, this is what I got to get done, and this is what it's going to get done. So it's helped me, and I'm pretty sure that if you ask anybody, having a set schedule pretty much makes things a little bit easier. Third rule is quality over quantity. Let's say that again.
Quality over quantity.
Now, I can't stress this enough. I don't think that it is necessarily necessary to post 300 posts in one day on Instagram, because you feel like the more that you post, the more engagement you're going to have, the more following you're going to have, the more brands are going to see you. I think that sticking to one post, maybe even two posts a day, because obviously if somebody's scrolling through their newsfeed and they see you 500 times, they're going to get annoyed. So obviously sticking to one to two posts a day, but making sure that those one to two posts are best quality that you could possibly produce, because that's what brands really want to see, is that they want to see that quality. So making sure that you are posting good quality with good lighting, and making sure that the makeup is actually seen in its natural, you know, whatever, then that's pretty much what you need. Cameras can get pretty expensive, and for equipment and everything, I mean, you're looking at least $3,000 to $5,000 just on equipment. Now, in my opinion, you don't really need to spend that money right away. Obviously, it's an investment. If you want to really take this seriously and you want to make this an investment, then that's totally up to you. It's your discretion. Obviously, I'm not going to tell you do not buy a camera, because that's not my, you know, decision to make. But I think that you can kind of get away with a smaller camera, or even the back of an iPhone X or the iPhone XS. Some of my pictures are actually off of my iPhone XS, because the quality of the camera is there, and it's a good camera. So you don't necessarily, you know, I'm not saying use your iPhone 4 either, because that just kind of totally defeats the purpose. Because obviously technology advances over time, so obviously if you're using a newer iPhone, I think that you can get away with it. Probably investing maybe a couple $100 in a small camera to begin with would be your best bet, but you don't have to go out and splurge and spend so much money on all this equipment. Now, over time, I have kind of bought my own equipment. I do have my lighting, I do have my backdrops, I do have my camera, but it's kind of like a thing that you kind of do over time. Once I start seeing, hey, this is what I really like to do, I'm gonna, you know, really take my time to do this, then I started getting more and more stuff. But obviously, when you first begin, you don't need to go out and purchase $5,000 worth of equipment, because it's not really necessary. When you are posting your pictures on Instagram, even your YouTube here on, or your YouTube videos here on YouTube, make sure that you are using hashtags. Hashtags are super important. It's kind of how brands and other people who are searching certain things. Let's say that somebody is searching for purple eyeshadow look. They're gonna look for a purple eyeshadow look under hashtags on Instagram. So if you are wearing purple eyeshadow, put it in your hashtags, put it in your caption. Make sure that you're tagging the brands that are you're using. So if I use LA Girl Foundation today, for example, when I post a picture, I'm gonna make sure that I put LA Girl Foundation and tag the brand, because I want them to see that I'm using their product, and then if they see my picture, they're probably gonna go and look at my profile. And if they like my profile, they'll probably repost me or something, you know? And that's just kind of how it works. You have to kind of put yourself out there. So make sure that your profile is on public, use a bunch of hashtags in your caption, and make sure that you are tagging brands. Now, when it comes to hashtags though, you want to be careful, because sometimes you can get shadow banned. So if you're using the same exact hashtags every single time and you're posting like 3 times a day, Instagram is going to kind of take it as spam, and they're going to do what's called shadow ban, which is basically make none of your hashtags be seen. So even if somebody looks up purple eyeshadow, your picture is not going to come up just because you are shadow banned. So make sure that you're super careful. Switch it up. Look up what are good. You can even Google what are popular trending hashtags right now on Instagram. So those are the hashtags that people are looking for. That's what you want to aim for. So switch it up every now and then. Put a brand as a hashtag kind of thing. So it's kind of just a trial and error thing. See what works for you. See what hashtags work for you. Obviously, one person might find certain hashtags helpful for them, and some might not find them helpful. So it's kind of trial and error, and see what kind of works for you. Don't be bummed out when one post does better than another, because that happens all the time. Not all of your posts are going to get the exact same likes, the exact same comments, the exact same engagement. Sometimes Instagram has better days. Some days more people are active online, and other days they're not. So sometimes, you know, on a Tuesday, for example, a lot of people may be online, but on a Saturday afternoon where people are out and about with their families, you know, going to parties, birthday parties, whatever it is, because it's the weekend, people might not be more active. So you kind of have to be aware of all of that. So like I said, it's more like a trial and error. See what kind of works for you and what doesn't, and then take those tips and grow from there. And I think it's one of the most important things that you have to keep in mind is basically don't do this for the money. If you're doing this because you know that YouTubers make money, that's not really the reason why you should start. And it's not really a good reason to even stay motivated, because once you see that it's a lot of work and it's a lot of time and effort, you're not going to always get that money right away. So another thing is, do not expect money, or do not expect free makeup just by doing this. Or, you know, if you start your account 1 week later, do not expect money to start rolling in, and do not expect free makeup to start rolling in, because I mean, I'm a year in, and sometimes I do get free makeup from brands, but it's not a lot compared to all these other makeup artists that are on here on Instagram. So that is the number one thing that you want to keep in mind. Do not start this for the money or for free makeup or anything, because that's definitely not going to get you anywhere. You're gonna not want to stay motivated, and it's gonna just discourage, it's not gonna encourage you to really do it anymore. You're gonna find yourself quitting after such little time, because there's so many influencers out there now. You have to find your own place in the makeup world, if that makes sense. So be yourself. Don't try to mimic anybody else. Kind of see what trends are you know, trending on Instagram as far as makeup looks, YouTube videos. There's a lot of challenges now, makeup challenges, like the 5-minute makeup challenge that I did once. That was all trending at the time. So you kind of have to pay attention to those and just do your own thing. People will come to you and brands will definitely see you if you're yourself and if they see that you have a smile on your face and that you're enjoying what you're doing. I know that I have been rambling and talking for a long time, but I really do hope that you guys take some of these tips and try them out for your own. And if you're thinking about doing something, not only does it have to be makeup, but maybe you're starting a nail page. Maybe you do nails on the side. If you start a hair page because you're a hairstylist, if you want to start any type of page, a car page, a photography page, any type of page at all, you know, these are great tips to kind of get you started with that. It's what has been working for me. Obviously, like I said, I don't have a huge following, but I'm definitely trying my best, and I'm pretty much doing this because it's honestly a lot of fun for me. I like to do this. This is my me time. This is what I feel like, wow, I get to accomplish something, and this is what I like to do. So that's pretty much why I do it and why I even started in the first place. So I hope that you guys enjoy this video, and I'll see you in my next one.